What is going on, you guys? DJ T Stokes. We are back here today with another video, and today in this video I will be teaching you guys how to fully wire a powered sound system for DJs, bands, or anything that you would need a sound system for. I've got a little bit of equipment behind me, and then we are also going to be using my two EVZLX15Ps and my new sub that I showed you guys in the last video. So I'm going to show you guys what's here and then we'll get right into it. Alright you guys, so this is just audio equipment, so there's not a lot here. I've got a mic stand and the tripods on the bottom there. I've got my mixer, sound meter right here, which I always carry with me. Wired microphone. This is the new wireless microphone you guys saw. My laptop and laptop stand. This is my cable bag, it's actually a tackle box. And then this is my 6-channel mixer. So personally, how I always set my stuff up and wire it is I always try to lay out the tripods and get everything centered in the room first. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to be the garage door as our audience. So the speakers will be facing the garage door so you guys can see how I'm plugging everything in and stuff. So let's get all of our tripods set up. All right, you guys can see that I have both my tripods set up now. And now the next step is going to be bringing our speakers and subwoofer and putting them in place. Obviously the speakers go on the tripods, and then typically I run my subwoofer underneath my table or right in front of my facade. For this video, it's going to be underneath the table. Alright, so as you guys can see, we've got our speakers on the tripods and our subwoofer, which I'm sitting on right here. And now we can get into wiring and putting everything on the table, including our mixer, DJ controller, and wireless microphones. So let's get into it. As you can see right here behind me, we have everything set up on the table. I've got my wireless microphone right here, right next to my mixer, so I just use a short XLR cable to go from there. I've got my wired microphone, which I have not yet set up, and then the DJ controller right here with my laptop on top. Right there is a pile of a lot of cables, and I know it looks like a mess, but they all have their place. These clips, I highly suggest everyone goes and picks up. They are gravity clips, and this clips onto your tripod, and it has a little hook here for your wires to go through, so it cleans up all your wires. No need for taping up your tripods or Velcro or doing any of that kind of stuff, and it gets rid of that really bad look on all your wires coming down from your tripods. So now what we're going to do is we're going to start cabling everything since we have everything in place. Now, a vast majority of my cables are brought to you by HOSA Technology, but not all of them are. I still have to buy a few more new HOSA ones, switching out from the old ones, but a lot of them are from HOSA, and they are not paying me or anything to say that. I just really like HOSA. Alright you guys, so at this point I am done giving everything power. My wireless mic is powered, my mixer is powered, my DJ controller runs off the laptop power so that does not need an external power source, and my speakers and subwoofer are all powered. I'll show you guys how I do that. Alright, so as you guys can see here, I have this blue cable coming in through there, and I have another one coming in through here. Now I suggest that you guys always get lighted ends on your cables so you know if you trip a circuit, what circuit you tripped. This cord right here is running all of my stuff on my table and this left speaker, and this other cord is running the subwoofer and the right speaker. Always make sure you know how much power your stuff draws so you know how many circuits you need and stuff like that. Alright you guys, so now you can see here that I have my XLRs going into my subwoofer, out of my mixer. And then from here, I will go out of my subwoofer to the left speaker and the right speaker according to the different channels. Alright, so this setup is completely cabled. It is cabled with power and XLR audio cables now, so it is pretty much a completely functioning setup. But even though it's functioning, we are not even close to done yet. As you can see right here, we've got all kinds of cables dangling down. Over there, we've got cables dangling down. Underneath the table, it doesn't really matter because I do have a facade, so that hides all of my cables. But if you don't have a facade and you just have a scrim, you really want to make sure that you tidy up all your cables underneath that. So now, as you guys can see, the cables are much more hidden on our tripods. On this side over here, I did use the gravity clips, and on this side, I used the Velcros just to show the difference. And you can use both, honestly. They both look very clean. I just prefer the gravity clips because they're a lot quicker and simpler to do. They are very easy to lose though. You can leave them behind at places and forget about them pretty easily. So now that we're all wired, let's turn on the power and I'll give you guys a walk through the setup. All right, so we've got everything booted up here, our wireless microphones, our mixer, the MacBook, and our DJ controller. And what's basically happening is this orange cable is feeding out of Serato into the DJ controller. And then the RCAs are coming out of the DJ controller into our external mixer. And these are actually quarter-inch plugs, as you guys can see right there. And then from there, we can plug in our microphones, which are the Shure UT4 receiver with an SM58. You guys saw that in the last video. And that allows us to have all the different levels and stuff on here to adjust that. From there, we have our XLRs. These guys go down here into our subwoofer. From our subwoofer, our left and right channel goes into the subwoofer and then out to our different speakers. So our left channel goes out to our left speaker and our right channel goes out to our right speaker. Now as you guys can see here, I tried to keep the cables nice and tidy with these gravity clips and stuff that I mentioned earlier, but if I was at a real event, I'd obviously tidy this up and then gaff tape my cables so no one trips. But these go up into our speakers. So I have this going into one of the inputs on my ZLXs and the other side going in right here. And that is basically it. You want to make sure you leave enough slack on your cables so nothing will rattle out or accidentally unplug, but that is basically it. Alright, I just powered everything up, the ZLXs are on, and these we have set to a 100 Hz crossover with the subwoofer. And then, if we wanted, we could connect our Shure wired microphone that's in here. But I typically just use this, and I use the wired one if I want to make any announcements. So I'm not even going to hook that up right now. Alright, so as you guys can see, I'm now talking through my wireless microphone through the sound system. And at a normal event or outside or barbecue or anything, I would obviously raise my speakers up, but the ceilings aren't very high in here, so I have them pretty low right now. Alright, so now in order to get sound coming out of our speakers, what do we need to do? I've got my crossfader set to my right channel, as you guys can see here, and I have a song, you can't really see that, on Serato up there. I'm going to raise my right fader up. And then on my external mixer here, I have my channel 5 and 6. I should turn that up, and then all I need to do is press play, and you've got sound. And obviously you need to make sure your master line is up on that. But as well, if I turn on my mic, I can talk through my mics. If I turn it up like this, you guys can now hear me. I forgot to mention, you guys, is that since it is the month of January, it is typically when NAMM would be happening. It is now happening virtually, I believe. I'm not entirely sure though, but a lot of DJ gear gets released. One piece that actually just got released today when I was recording this video was the Rain 1 controller. Now Rain just came out with this controller and it has motorized platters, which is really cool, as well as your microphone input adjustment knobs on the front right here. One thing that drives me crazy about the SV3, it is an awesome controller, but it has the mic input and, well, it has the mic input adjustment, I should say, on the back. So it's really hard to adjust during a gig if you need to. That is going to be really nice on the Rain 1 controller because it will have the adjustments on the front of it. Now that controller, I have heard, starts at $1,400, which I think is a little bit steep of a price, but it is a really nice controller and it is motorized, so I'm not sure how much value the motors add to it price-wise, if you will. But I think it's going to be a really, really cool controller, and it's going to be a different controller, which is honestly what we need. So just wanted to give you guys an update on that, and I'll let you know about any more gear that comes out. Alright you guys, that's it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, share this video with your friends, and leave a comment below if you enjoyed. And as you guys can see, I've got my speakers off the tripods, and I'm gonna start breaking down. Surprisingly, this little setup only takes about, 30 minutes to set up if you're just hustling and getting it done. It's not a very big setup, which is nice. So that's why I enjoy it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll see you next time.
I see the sky, it's so beautiful and blue.